What's up internet, I am Manish from RebellionRider.com where we make learning SQL, PLSQL and Oracle database fun. Now that we have learned the concepts of first bound clause, which is lower and upper bound in the last tutorial, let's move ahead and learn how to use for all statement with the second bound clause, that is indices of. As we learned in the previous tutorial that for all statement takes the data from the collection and stores it into a table. Thus, we will start this tutorial by creating a table for holding the data. Here is the table. This table has only one column, MUL underscore tab of number data type. Except from the name, the structure of this table is pretty much the same as the one we created in the previous tutorial. Let's execute this create table statement and create our table. Table created. So before we jump onto this tutorial and start learning how to write a for all statement with indices of bound clause, let's just do a quick demonstration and learn what exactly is the need of indices of bound clause when we have a bound clause like lower and upper bound. Here is a PLSQL block. In this block, I have created a nested table with the name my underscore nested underscore table. Right after creating this nested table, I have also initialized its first 10 indexes by storing 10 numeric elements into it using its collection variable var underscore nt. This nested table is a dense collection because the indexes of this collection are populated consecutively. But if you look at the first statement in the execution section, you will find that using collection method delete, I have deleted data from index 3 to index 6, which means that now the indexes of our collection is not populated sequentially. That changes the nature of our collection from dense to sparse. Followed by the collection method delete call, we have a for loop, which will print the data stored into the index if it exists. Otherwise, it will print a formatted string alerting the user that there is no data stored into the index. Let's execute this program and see the result. Here is the result. As you can see that, except from the index number 3 to 6, all the other indexes have some data stored into them. Now we are sure that our collection my underscore nested underscore table is a sparse collection. Now let's see what happens if we use for all statement with the first bound clause, which is lower and upper bound, with this sparse collection. First, let's just close this output panel. Okay, now let's modify this code. The work of this for loop is to show us whether we have data stored into the index or not. I think it has done its work and we don't need it anymore. So let's get rid of this and write our for all statement in its place. Here we have our for all statement. Using this statement, we are taking the data from our collection and storing it into the table tut underscore 78. Also, in this statement, we have used 1 as our lower bound and 10 as our upper bound, which means this statement will traverse through the index number 1 to index number 10 of our collection. Let's execute this program now and see what will happen. Here we got an error saying the element at index number 3 does not exist. The shortcoming of the lower and upper bound clause is that we cannot use it with sparse collection. We can easily solve this error by using a bound clause like indices of or values of. So let's move on and learn how to overcome this shortcoming of lower and upper bound clause by using indices of with for all statement. Indices of bound clause comes handy when the bulk data processing involves a sparse collection. Let's see how to write a for all statement with indices of clause. Once again, just to save the time, let's modify this same block. This time, we just have to modify the for all statement. But first, let's close this script output. Okay, now let's do it. Here is our modified for all statement. Let's take a look. The statement starts with the keyword for all, followed by a loop counter. You can name it whatever you want. Like here, we named it IDX. Followed by the loop counter, we have another keyword in, and then our bound clause, that is indices of. Right after writing the reserved phrase indices of, we have to specify the collection whose data you want to use. Like in our case, we want to use the data of our collection, which is my underscore nested underscore table. As we know, we referenced the collection in the program through its collection variable. That is why we wrote the name of the collection variable var underscore nt here. In our case, var underscore nt is a collection variable of our collection my underscore nested table. That is the definition of our for all statement. Using this statement, we are inserting the data from our collection into the mul underscore tab column of table tut underscore 78. That's all about this for all statement. Just to verify that we have fetched and inserted the right number of rows, let's add one more thing. This variable will hold the total number of rows inserted into the table after fetching them from the collection. Here in the execution section, we have added two statements. Among these, the first one is a select into statement, which will return the total number of rows inserted into the table tut underscore 78 and will store that value into the variable tot underscore rec, which we just declared. Remember, here I'm assuming that the table is freshly created and no data is stored into it. The second statement is an output statement, which is displaying back the value stored into the variable tot underscore rec with a formatted string. Can you guess what could be the result of this DBMS output statement? Yes, the correct answer is 6. Why? Okay, let me show you why. In declaration section, we initialized our nested table with 10 elements. Then in the execution section, we deleted 4 elements. After deleting those 4 elements from index 3 to 6, we are left with only 6 elements. That is why the answer of this output statement should be 6. Let's execute and see the result. As we guessed, the output is 6, which means we have fetched 6 elements from the collection and stored them into our table. Since we haven't put any restrictions in the program, therefore each time we execute it, it will keep on adding the same 6 elements again and again. So for example, if the first output is 6, then on second execution it will be 12, because the program will append the same 6 elements again into the table. Now, you guys have to tell me how to solve this problem. Go ahead and comment your ideas down below. That being said, let's wind up today's tutorial. So, in this tutorial we learned how to overcome the shortcoming of the first bound clause, along with how to use for all statement with sparse collection using indices of clause. Hope you enjoyed watching and learned something new. Do make sure to give this video a thumbs up. Also, share this with your friends on your social media. More importantly, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.